Hello everyone, I'm here with another unboxing video for you. It's been a little while. Haven't really been buying much these days. Can't afford to, really, and I don't really have time to paint much these days, so I'm trying to be very picky in what I get. So, today we have Rayvin's Micro-naut. So, let's see. Didn't do anything yet. All I did was just open the box, and that's how everything was. This is so cute. Enjoy the little spicy fellas. So we have a card and a little post-it. So cute. What do we got? Peanuts. So for two micros, this is awesome, awesome packing. Look at this. Definitely safe traveling from Canada to the United. Look at this cool sticker. Brings back so many memories.
Like childhood and like Lisa Frank.
I'm keeping that. Save that for later. All right, so, oh wow, these are like big containers. I thought they were like teeny tiny. All right, let's see what we got. Put these back in here. Oh goodness, this is where I make a mess. All right. So, I got two little Micro-nauts because I have ideas. This is awesome. These things are great for traveling and going to shows and stuff. I'll put a link in the description of a bunch of the ones I've seen and used and such in case you need them. I don't know if they're these exact ones, but they would be similar. All right, so we got some cute confetti tissue paper. Oh my goodness. Now that is some packing. That is some packing. We got little stickers. Little stickers. Oh, is this too bright? Let's lower this. Is it too bright? Ooh, too low. Yeah, that'll be good. And let it open up our little Micro-naut. See how it is. Ooh. Can we zoom in anymore? Let's see if we can zoom. Oh, that's about it. So let's see if I can change the lighting here. Sorry. Focus. All right, we do need bright light. So here he is. I didn't even actually get to look at him close yet, but I'm just putting him in the camera here so you guys can see. If I push this down. Oops, sorry. Just trying to get the light on him so you can see the detail. I'll take a closer look in a second. That's why I'm not being like, oh, because I haven't really looked at him yet, but just trying to get the shot here. Okay, so let me look at him. If I can, oh, my eyeballs. All right, throw that off. I can't see anything. Because it's dark in here, and this light's too bright. Holy mackerel, there's like no printer lines on this. I see a couple, like on his back. But that's crazy. You'd never like know this was 3D printed. That's cool. Yeah, so it looks like the only really sanding you'll need would be like his back here, where you can see the lines, but I don't really see them anywhere else, especially in any of the detail areas. Maybe a teensy bit here, but that might get hidden with primer, but he is awesome. Look at the detail in that tail. It's so delicate, like, looking, but it seems that's pretty darn sturdy. Very cool. Let's open his base and see what his base is like. I'm very excited. I really want to paint one of these. I've worked with these 3D prints before, but I've never like painted one or like worked on it fully. It was just sort of like a test type deal for someone. And so I'm really excited to start checking that out. I mean, that's cool. You could actually see the printer lines on the bottom of this, but that doesn't really even matter. That's neat. Look at his cool base. Look at that. That's really cool. Plop him up in there and see how that goes. Oh, wow, he fits in there. Nice. Oh, that is nice. That's cool. Like, I don't know, like, why. It's just he fits in there so nice and it's just like, he's, like, look at that. I love it. I can't wait. Cannot wait. Awesome. So you probably have to be careful if you paint the pegs because it
may not go in as easy, so you got to be careful to not put too much, like, you probably don't want to paint the pegs or that, because he's in there really nice right now, and you don't really want to mess with that too much. So there he is. There's Micro-naut. Pretty awesome. So you wonder if, because you can kind of see the legs a little bent. I wonder if it's supposed to be that way, or if that was a little warped. Let's see. Let's open this one and see if it's the same. Because if it's exactly the same, then it's probably supposed to be like that. Because I don't see it from straight down. I only saw it in the camera. I see it a little bit looking straight on at the hook, but let's see. Yeah, that's pretty much the same. I mean, probably supposed to be that way. Yeah. So that's exciting. Let's see how these lines compare. Yep, it's about the same. The lines be a little less noticeable than the other one, but they're there. That's all right. They should stand off. I'm really impressed. Like, as far as 3D printing's come. I have a 3D printer, but it's like one of the older ones when they first started kind of coming out, and it's really low quality. It was, you know, better then, but now with today's standard of these, this is crazy. So we're probably going to be seeing a lot more of these in the hobby, which is good because it probably saves artists a lot of time and trouble getting these out to you guys. You know, it might just cost a little more because of a little extra, like, effort and supply costs involved, but totally worth it in the end, I think, for everyone involved. So I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, share, all that good stuff, and I will see you next time. Thank you, Rayvin. Bye.